The GS Series VFDs from Automation Direct are already pretty easy to use with the Do More PLC. You can either connect them via multi-drop RS-45 or use the eDrive 100 Ethernet to serial converter so you can talk to the drives via Ethernet network. In both cases, you would use the Do More Modbus commands to read and write to the drives. That's pretty easy, but every time you want to do anything with the drive, you have to go through the whole send a command, wait for the command to finish, verify the command ritual to ensure a robust drive control, right? Wouldn't it be great if you could just control the drive with some reads and writes to local memory and have the Do More take care of all that tedious stuff for you? Well, guess what? That's exactly what the Ethernet I/O does. You just enable the Ethernet I/O feature, and now you control the drive as if it were simple local I/O by reading and writing to a built-in GS drive structure. Let's take a look. We're using the same hardware we had in our quick start video, a Do More base, an EBC-100 slave, a Terminator slave, and an eDrive 100 GS drive combo that we want to talk to in this video. Check out the quick start video to see how to set things up. But really, all you do is enable the Ethernet I/O feature here by checking that checkbox, click on Ethernet I/O master, automatically scan the network for available hardware, and select the items you want to talk to. My system's already set up, so we'll just say OK. And that's it. My GS drive now appears to my program as just another local device. If I look at my memory tree over here, I can see under GS eDrive, a GS drive structure. That's for the new GS eDrive I just added. If I had 8 drives out there, I would see 8 structures. If I want to see all the members of that data structure, I just click on this plus sign, and you can see all the things you can access on that GS drive. You can set the speed of the drive, you can run the drive, you can set the direction of the drive, you can use some of these block transfers, watch the output current, the output frequency, all kinds of things. Well, accessing that is as simple as bringing up a data view and typing it in down here. The name of that guy was $GS120. And suppose I want to monitor the output frequency. Well, there it is. Suppose I want to be able to run and stop the drive. Well, same thing. I get my structure dot run command. Suppose I want to set the speed of the drive. Well, same thing. GS drive dot, and if I want to scan down through the list, I can do that. And there's my speed reference right there. What if I want to set the direction of the drive? Same thing. GS drive dot direction. Well, let's try it. Let's go ahead and put the PLC in run mode. I'm going to set my new speed to 50 hertz. There's an implied decimal, so I have to put 500 in there. And I want the drive to start running. So I just put a 1 here and write it out. And sure enough, I see my output frequency slowly ramping up to 50 hertz. I have a long acceleration time set up right now so y'all can see this ramp up. If I put a 0 in here, that says stop the drive. And sure enough, the drive ramps down to 0. So think about it. We're actually controlling a remote drive via local reads and writes to the elements of this data structure, which we can also see in our memory tree up here. The Do More takes those values and does all the cumbersome Modbus stuff in the background for us. How cool is that? Now I'm doing this all from the data view just to show you that all this stuff is just sitting here ready for your ladder program to use however it wants. By the way, side note here, if you don't see the GSE drive structure under the memory category in your tree over here, that means you have it sorted differently than I do. If you click on this button here, you can sort the memory in lots of different ways. I'm using this method right here. If you pick one of these other ones, the GS drive structure is still there, but you may have to dig a little deeper to find it. Now, one thing to keep in mind is this structure right here only has commands that you commonly need quick access to, like run, stop, setting the frequency, monitoring the frequency, all those things. Well, what if we want to change a parameter that isn't in the data structure, like the acceleration time, for example? Normally, we would do a Modbus write or just enter it directly into the drive via the front panel buttons, right? And since we usually set lots of parameters just to ensure everything is exactly the way we want it, that equals lots of Modbus reads and writes and or lots of manual entries. Wouldn't it be great if you could do your drive initialization with just one command? Well, guess what? Ethernet I/O has dedicated GS drive commands that do exactly that. So for a simple example, let's just set up the basic drive parameters for this drive. Well, that's easy. Come over here, and I want the GS register write command. If I double click on row 1 here, Look at this. Here's a listing of all the possible drive commands you might want to use. It's a great handy reference, but it also helps fill in the blanks for you. So we're going to do these parameters right here. The nameplate voltage. If I click on that, look what happens. It tells me the range of possible values for that parameter, a description of the parameter, a place to put my data, which I want that to be 230 volts, and what parameter that's going to go in. There are no implied decimal places, and the default value for this is 240. Awesome. Let's do another parameter. Double click on the row. I want to do the motor base frequency. Well, I can see that's 50, 60, or 400 hertz. I know I want mine to be 60 hertz. That's going to go into parameter 2. It's the motor base frequency. There are no implied decimal places. That's good. And my default value is 60. Great. Let's do another one. Let's do the amps factor this time. And I can see that the rated amps can go from 0.3 to 1.0. I see the name of the parameter. But look here. The implied decimal places. There's one implied decimal place. So if I want to set this to 1.0, that means I need to put a 10 here. So how cool is that? All the information you need to correctly set a drive parameter is right here in front of you. And if you're still not sure, look at this. There's two buttons here. They'll take you directly to the specs or the GS drive manual. I can pop up the manual directly from the Automation Direct website, look up the AC drive parameters, and find out everything I want to know. Now keep in mind, that's a direct link to the Automation Direct website, so these only work if you have access to the internet. But regardless, how easy is this? All the parameters right in front of you, you just click on the one you want, fill in the blanks, and say OK. And I can keep on going. You can add up to 50 parameters in a single instruction. The instruction will execute all those parameters, take care of all the Modbus reads and writes for you, and when it's done, it'll set a bit, which I'm using C0 for. On error, it'll set a different bit, which my personal preference is C99, and I say OK. Well, that's it. In one instruction, I can configure my drive. And look at this. Because this instruction is edge triggered, I don't even really need a contact here, right? The first time the program runs, this will see the rising edge, it'll execute that, and it'll never execute it again. Or I could put a contact here and say only do this on first scan, or I could even just drop this into an initialization routine that has a bunch of these for all my different drives. Lots of things I could do, but it's all set up to make it easy for you. The main thing is you can do your drive configuration with one line of ladder code, and then operate the drive doing local reads and writes to this data structure. No Modbus reads or writes anywhere. How about that? Well, that should be enough to get you started with using the GS drives via Ethernet I/O on the Do More. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series for more tips on using the Do More PLC. And don't forget, Automation Direct's tech support is always free, and you'll talk to a real live person here in the US within minutes. Got a question? You can call, email, or even do online chat during regular business hours. Whatever you prefer. Spend less, do more from Automation Direct.